Welcome to this very special occasion. This indeed is a historic event. You are here for the inauguration of an 80-foot Bailey Bridge.
Well, I'm Peter Oram. In my civilian life, I'm an usherman and a grower of landscape plants here in Illinois. In the military life I had in Denmark, I ended up being an engineer officer with the rank of a first lieutenant. We have with us here Captain P.K. Madsen. We served at the same Jutland Engineer Regiment back in the 1960s.
That's right.
We actually had not met at the time we served in the same regiment. We did not meet until just a couple of years ago when this whole Bailey Bridge project came about. A Bailey Bridge made of British Bailey equipment that both of us worked with in the 1960s. The Bailey Bridge was decommissioned from the Danish Army in the 1990s. We had a nurseryman from Denmark. They were on a visit here, and he came to one of the shootings that we have with the Royal Guard Society. So as we are sitting after the shooting, having something to eat and something to drink, there's talk about military service and what we had done. There was talk about bridges, and this man, Ole Skellerup, then says, "I think I know where there is a Bailey Bridge." Well, we smiled politely, and nobody really believed it. But I said that I would like him to show it to me next time I came to Denmark. So a year later, when I had an opportunity, Ole's son, Morten, actually took us out in the bushes at the corner of the golf course. We pushed the bushes aside, and here stood part of a Bailey Bridge, the whole package.
It has probably been through France. It helped bring the Allied armies from Normandy to the German heartland. You could very well have seen this very equipment over the River Rhine.
Of course, being an old bridge builder, the Bailey Bridge had a special place in my heart. And when I saw it, I just couldn't think of this thing going to a scrapyard and be melted down.
Talk with the manager on the golf course and say, "I have a guy who wants that bridge." I got the permission to say to Peter, "Okay, that bridge is yours if you want it."
And then we started cranking up the whole thing. Finn Agar, who is here with Midwest and also a part of the Royal Guard Society, got linked up with PK. Then the wheels started to roll. So when the decision was made, PK came over as a scouting mission to plan for where it should be. We felt it could fit in with the area with the barrack and the rifle range and the lake there. When the three ocean containers then came in July with all the equipment, Finn Agar and Robert Adolf and their helpers unloaded it, then the next step was to prepare it for the building.
Some of the wood was rotten. And I told Peter that I had to make a new planks and so on.
And it was more rusty than it looked like. We had to sandblast it and paint it all over again. So we contracted with Eric Balum and Mike to do that job. And that is really where the Mexican soldiers that we saw in the inauguration started, because all this equipment now had to be sandblasted on one place. Then you turn it and sandblast the other side. Then you spray paint it with primer, and then you turn it, and finally it came out with this World War II Army color, which is not the one used now. So by the time that PK and Mayor Carlson came over for the actual building, these Mexicans actually had some knowledge about how to handle it.
And the eight Mexican people was a minimum, because the heaviest piece of the bridge weighed about 400 kilos, so there should be eight men to carry it.
So there was PK and his assistant, Major Carlson from Sweden, Finn Agar reached out from Midwest, and then the eight Mexican soldiers. Normally such a bridge would take how many?
48 people.
48 soldiers.
Yes, and one officer and five sergeants.
PK, with these 11 people, built it in 4 days. It went very well.
Yeah.
Thank you. course, the obvious thing was to do that, like we did actually when we built military bridges. We always had a ribbon over it and had the trucks of the unit drive over the bridge. We did that always, didn't we?
Yes.
Every time.
Every time.
I think we can say that with the whole inauguration, the flag raising, the driving over the bridge and busting the ribbon, we are very happy here.
Very, very happy, Peter.
It was really good.